Hey Internet Cyclonius here, welcome to another video. And this video is going to be centered around Trudeau and the military and the trucker freedom convoy that is in Ottawa right now protesting the vaccine mandates and the mandates in general as a result of the pandemic that has infected the world. Only in this case, the Canadian version. So what we're seeing here now is the question of should the government, federal government of Canada, use the military to quell the protests that are occurring right now in Ottawa. Of course, Trudeau says right now there's no plan at the moment for the military to be used to stop the protests. According to the Washington Post, it says, quote, one has to be very, very cautious before deploying the military in situations engaging Canadians. He continues and he says, quote, it is not something that anyone should enter lightly, but as of now, there has been no requests and that is not in the cards right now. End quote. So what's that mean? Basically what he's saying is, look, right now, at the moment, nope, we're not going to use troops, the military, to stop the protests. And with good reason. There are several reasons why Trudeau doesn't want to use the military. One, his popularity, the waning of his popularity. It's already in the tanker or in the basement. Or very low. To use and bring in the military would make the situation, in terms of his popularity, much worse. Everyone knows that he's not a popular prime minister. The honeymoon period has long been passed. As a result of the pandemic, the popularity of this prime minister has tanked. And again, you know, you have to look at it from the perspective of optics. What would happen if the prime minister said, you know what, calling the military, we're calling them in, and we're going to disband these protests and arrest these people and charge them for civil disobedience. All these charges of what they're doing to the January 6th protesters down that happened in Washington, D.C. last year. So, it's a situation of optics. Then, of course, if he responds with the military, Justin Trudeau, now you have a huge PR disaster incoming because the world is watching what's happening in Ottawa. World leaders are watching, and let's say Trudeau decides to quell the protests, okay, now you have all these countries out there, in particular India, that will say, wait a second, wait. And letting them protest. And now you're doing the exact opposite of what you were telling us. So you see the optics games. Plus, what if countries decide to sanction economically Canada? Things are already bad as they are economically. Now, to put that kind of pressure on the Canadian government, in addition to what's happening now, that's not good. So, in terms of optics, Canadian government has to tread very carefully. And I really do think that if the trucker convoy protests continue, they will put enough pressure on the government that they have to force their hand. I really do think that the military won't be deployed unless there's a situation where, okay, now the behavior of the truckers has put the safety and security of the citizens of Ottawa at risk. Do I think that's going to happen? No, I don't think so. Again, it's all an optics game. It's all about what you see and what's perceived. And the truckers right now have enough momentum going forward that as long as they keep their folks in line and nothing stupid happens, then you know what? There's no need for the military to be called. Because they haven't given the government the excuse to say, you see, the truckers are acting a fool, so we have to go in, take them out, arrest them, and bring peace and security back to the city. So that's why I think the military won't be called. As long as the truckers keep protesting the way they're protesting, there won't be a situation where the excuse is given for the military to come in. That's my view. Again, I'm not attuned to Canadian politics and how they protest. Although I will say that in a short matter of time, they've been able to garner the attention of the world, and now all eyes are on the Canadian government. So on to the Washington Post article, the police chief over there, Peter Slully, basically is, he's not the most popular police chief at the moment, because he's saying that, hey, you know, we should have the military come in and help us out. Because what's happening, again, according to him, the protesters are not behaving. Again, this is according to the police chief over in Ottawa. He says, quote, "This demonstration has been intolerable, unprecedented. The range of illegal, dangerous, and unacceptable activities is beyond the ability to list, and the time that we have here today," end quote. But again, they don't, he doesn't elaborate what's going on. Well, what kind of illegal activities are you talking about here? Because again, when you're protesting, you know, you're in the street, you're yelling, you're honking your horn, being drunk, singing. Is that illegal in Canada? I highly doubt it. But there have been reports of people freaking out because of the horns, the truck horns. And believe me, they could be very, very loud. So again, what is this police chief trying to say? It's all optics, folks. It's all optics. And how it's perceived. If the Canadian truckers are perceived as folks who are just fighting for their freedoms, which they are, then, and they're protesting peacefully, which they are, then what would be the reason for Trudeau to send in the military? It's an open, honest question. What would be the reason to send in the military? What illegal act or treasonous act that these protesters have done that would call for the military to be called in? Again, you know, when you're protesting, it's the intention is not to make things lovey-dovey and comfortable. Simple as that. Its intent is to draw attention to a problem or set of problems, and for people to come together to discuss the problem and to come to a solution. Look at what happened over, was it, is it Alberta or Saskatchewan, where the authorities now are saying, all right, we, because of the truckers, indirectly, of course, we're reconsidering the vaccine passport or health pass, and we're going to do away with it. So, again, they didn't give credit to the truckers, but because of the truckers threatening and actually blockading highways and making life inconvenient for the government in those aforementioned provinces, they forced the hand of the government. Again, no violence, no need for the military to be called in, but they forced the hand of the government. And that's the hope here in Ottawa, but done collectively around the whole of Canada. So take it, you know, take it from someone that's read a lot about history. When you bring the military in, you become heavy-handed, you look bad. The government will look very bad. And people are going to start questioning, hey, man, what are you doing? These people are protesting peacefully, and here you are being heavy-handed. So you see the optics that the government does not want. And what's to say? Trudeau does call in the military. And now the people, collectively, become against the government and him. Now he's in a situation where, damn, look what I did. And now, if I don't call back the military, the people are going to be calling for my head to resign. And now the situation is much worse. Now my political career is done. So, again, optics. It's all optics. And that's why the military, using the military, it's not just something that you just go, okay, guys, let's stop it. Because it can escalate. It can escalate from what was something that was peaceful to now you got people getting slammed with batons, fighting. It, no one wants that. I don't want that. You know, my first reaction to all this nonsense was violence. To instigate, not instigate violence, but to respond with violence if the police come in and try to stop the protest. And I just mean that in general. But when you look at history and you see how Gandhi and you see how Martin Luther King got their points across, they did it peacefully. And sometimes you need to take a step back and go, wait, if I use violence to get my point across, then I'm no better than the government doing what it's doing. Because now I'm acting the way the government's acting. And you don't want that. No one wants that. So that's why I was like, wait a second. Yeah, you use violence as a last resort. That's, you just don't open up your protest with violence. It just doesn't work that way. Again, it's all optics. It's all optics. If you start with violence, again, the way I was originally thinking, then you don't do yourself and your cause a favor. You're not doing your cause a favor. As a matter of fact, you're going to turn people against you very quickly. So that's why it's important to do things peacefully until you have no other choice. Until your back is against the wall and you have nowhere else to go and there's a boot about to be put on your neck and a gun pointing at your head, then maybe, yeah, it's probably time to push back. Somehow. So again, that was my logic initially. And again, yeah, violence will work, yes, but it doesn't make you in the right. So that's my analysis of the situation over in Canada, with regards to using the military. Again, using the military has never, ever, ever worked out nicely. I've never seen a situation where the military has been used and everything was lovey-dovey in the end. So that being said, guys, that's my take. That's my analysis. Hopefully, my analysis is correct, that Trudeau will not call in the military. As long as it remains the way it's going, the military won't be called in. I don't to save his political career, I don't think he will call in the military. So, with that being said, guys, Canadian truckers in general, stay safe. I hope for the truckers over in Canada, I hope you succeed in what you're trying to bring about to the forefront. Stay safe, guys, and freedom is worth fighting for. Peace.